From DocuSign, this is Developing with DocuSign. This video is a continuation of our multi-part instructional series on how to migrate your application from DocuSign Legacy Auth to OAuth. My name is Nima Polat, a developer advocate with DocuSign. In this video, I will tackle Python applications. Please check out our videos in this series for other SDK languages. Am I using insecure legacy auth? How do I know which authentication method I'm using in my integration? The simplest way to find out which authentication method you are using is to search for x-docusign-authentication in your code. If you find that keyword and if you see yourself setting that header in your DocuSign calls, then you're using legacy authentication. You should start planning to migrate your integration to newer auth methods, as DocuSign will stop supporting legacy authentication in September of 2022 for applications currently in production. Let's look at the following example together. Here we have a simple code snippet that lists the envelopes in your account. To authenticate, we're setting the x-docusign-authentication header with your account password and username in plain text. It goes without saying that this is insecure. Let's go ahead and change this code to a better, more secure JWT authentication. But before we do so, we need to gather some information from our admin dashboard. First, let's go ahead and collect some information that we're going to need to perform OAuth. Navigate to your apps and keys page. And then find the integrator key that you will be using in your integration. Then navigate down to RSA key pairs and generate a pair. You want to go ahead and save the public key and your private key in a safe location, as you will needing them in order to perform OAuth. Next up, you want to navigate to the user page and you want to find the user ID of the user that you'll be impersonating. So select the user and go ahead and open it. And make note of the API username. This is the user ID that you'll be using to impersonate when you use OAuth. All right, now let's look at our code after migration to the new OAuth 2.0 authentication. There are a couple of notable differences that we'll discuss here. First, we're using a JWT auth grant flow here. This is the easiest way to migrate your code away from legacy auth. If the account user is not present, or the web browser can be redirected, then the legacy HUD should be replaced with JWT grant. In your scopes variable, you'll define the scopes you need. For e-signature applications, use the signature scope. The impersonation scope is assumed and is not needed in a JWT grant request. You then specify the user ID that you're impersonating when calling request_JWT_user_token. You will also need to use the RSA key you created previously, along with your integrator key, and include the private key as a byte array when you call request_JWT_user_token. The private key is used to digitally sign the token payload before sending it to the request. After the JWT method returns the access key, set the authorization header by calling setDefaultHeader. Please keep in mind that the token is only valid for an hour, and you need to get a new token when the old one expires. Use the same access token to make API calls while the token is valid. Do not get a new access token for every API call. Only get a new access token when your application is about to make an API call and the old token has expired or will expire within the next 10 minutes. The rest of your code remains intact. That's it. It really is that simple to migrate your auth from insecure legacy auth over to the latest OAuth that our SDK supports. Thank you for joining us today. Please be sure to subscribe to our channel so you can follow the future videos that I'll be posting in this series. Thank you so much.